out there, this is Magnus, and I will try to explain this Songo groove that I just played. And in this video, I will only focus on the mechanics of it, the sticking, and so just you can start to practice the Songo groove. But to make it feel good and get the Latin feel of it and everything like that, that will be in another video, because this will just contain the basics of this groove. All right, so let me start with the hands. And the right hand plays on 1 and 3. And this groove contains of 2 bars. Both bars plays right hand on 1 and 3, like this. You can play it on hi-hat, you can play it on rim, you can play it on the side of the floor tom or on the ride bell. Or, you know, whatever, but I will focus on the hi-hat here now. So, on 1 and 3 in these 2 bars, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2, 3, 4. All right, that's pretty easy. Yes, it is. So let's move on to the left hand and what the left hand is doing. We start with beat 2. That's where the first hit from the left hand. And I play side stick here. So it'd be something like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And 1, 2, 3, 4. So we just focus on the first bar now and what the left hand is doing in that bar. The next hit with the left hand will be on the end of 3. Something like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And 1, 2, 3, 4. And 1, 2, 3, 4. All right, and now we add the last hit with the left in the first bar, and that will be on the end of 4. Something like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2, again, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2, again, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1. All right, there you have the first bar and what the hands are doing. Now we move on to the second bar. And as I mentioned, the right hand plays on 1 and 3, exactly the same thing. The left hand plays almost the same thing. We just add another hit on the end of 1. Something like this, if I play the whole groove first. In the second bar, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2. Again, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2. Again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. Let's stop there. And so, beat 1, the hi-hat, then it comes to the end, 1 and, there you have the next side stick, the left hand. Next hit is on beat 2, so 1, 2, okay, 1, 2, then we come to beat 3, we have the right hand again, so 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2, 3, 4. Now we add the next left hand hit, and that will be on the end of 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. 1, 2, 3, and 4. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And 1, 2, 3, and 4. All right. And now we add the last hit, which will be on the end of 4. Slowly, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, again, and 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1. There you have the second bar and what the hands are doing. Let's go back to the first bar. Do you remember that one? It was like this. 1, 2, 3, four. And the second bar was three, four, one, two, three, four. So let's try to put these together now. All right. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. And one. Last time. All right. So there we have the hands, and yes, it sounds like a robot is playing so far, but as I mentioned, I will go into the other stuff in the next video, how to get it feel more like a Latin player is playing it, and you know, make it more organic, so to speak. But now let's move on and get to the bass drum. And this will be the tricky part. And because we are so used to play the bass drum on the downbeat, but here we play it on the end of two and on beat four, actually. So one, two, three, four, and one, two, and three, and four, and one, and two, and three, and four, and one, and two, one, three, and four, and. You can also play it only on the end of two. It, you know, it differs a bit, you know. But let's try to learn it now to play just on the end of two in the beginning. So if you take the first bar first, it sounds like this without the kick drum. One, and two, three, and four, and one, two, three, four. Now I will add the kick drum on the end of two in the first bar. So one and two and three and four and one, two, three, four, one, two, three, again, one, two, three, four, one, two, again, and one, two, three, four, one, two, three, again, and one, two, three, four. And four. All right. Let's move on to the second bar and add that kick drum on the end of two. It sounded like this. Three, four, one, and two, and three, and four, and one, two. Without kick. One, and two, and three, and four. With kick. Three, and four, and one, and two, and three, and four, and one, two, three, and four, and one, and two, four and one, two and three and four and one, two and three and four and one. There you have the second bar, how it sounds with the kick drum. And this is the tricky part, as I mentioned before. So maybe you need to like write this down and really focus, okay, when is this kick drum coming compared to what the hands are doing. Some students that I have done that and it helped a lot. And of course you need to spend time doing this. So, all right, let's try to add the both bars together with the kick drum on the end of two now, all right? One, two, three, four, and one, two, three, four, and one. So, before I close this video, I will add the kick drum on four also, so you can hear and try to follow that. So, I play about the same tempo as I did, but now I will add the kick drum on 4/2 in each bar. It will sound something like this. One, two, three, four, one, two, three, four. have it. So try to get the hands together first and then add the feet. Some students think it's easier if I, you know, get the kick drum working by itself. So like you count 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, and then you add 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. It's so different how we work as in our brains. So some think this is easier to do it like that, and some think it's easier to, you know, write it down and, you know, focus on where does it come compared to the hands, as I mentioned earlier also. So, well, you know, give it time and just try to get this mechanics working. So in the next video, I will try to, you know, make it feel better also with accents, dynamics and different orchestrations, etc. So I hope you enjoy this and welcome to subscribe, of course, to this YouTube channel. You find me here on YouTube, you find me on Instagram, if you search for at Druminspiration also. Thank you very much for watching, and please leave a comment if you like this, and have a great day. Bye bye.